I remember a senator once asked me, when we talk about CIA, why we never use the word the in front of it. And I asked him, do you put the word the in front of God?
And this officially was released by the CIA, talking about how they have people embedded in all the major media to change, alter, and affect stories to their benefit.
Traveling map. Tony, this better work, pal, or you'll be a digital memory.
Take it easy, Damon. We're loading Richard's image onto the database, and when he's mapped onto the stunt double, you'll never know the difference. All right, boys. Let's see you dance.
Sensational. I love it!
Dismantle all the overlays. Put the digital mat into pixel memory storage. You know, the damn thing worked like a charm.
It should. Edit'll charge us an arm and a leg for the software. Damon, you didn't have to kill him.
It's all a part of life's rich pattern, Brenda. And you better fucking get used to it.
But that's not true.
They were taken to Cadre Memorial.
Introduce tonight's guest runner. And watch that screen.
Our star runner tonight needs no introduction. He's Ben Richards, the brutal slayer of 60 men, women, and children in the Bakersfield Massacre.
Food riot in progress. Approximately 1,500 civilians moving in.
Yankee 9-9er, the crowd is unarmed. Repeat, unarmed. Abort attack. Acknowledge Yankee 9-9er.
The hell with you.
Lieutenant Sanders, take command. Detain Richards and return to base.
Watch that screen.
Yankee 9-9er, what's the status of the crowd?
Food riot in progress. Approximately 1,500 civilians. No weapons are evident.
Proceed with Plan Alpha. Eliminate anything moving.
I said the crowd is unarmed. There are lots of women and children down there. All they want is some food, for God's sake.
As you were, Richards. Proceed with Plan Alpha. All rioters must be eliminated.
The hell with you. I will not fire at helpless human beings.
Where's it coming from?
Network satellite.
Turning now to the group that instigated the Covington incident, the Black Hebrew Israelites. I do think some of your members are giving you guys a bad name. Let's just watch some just recordings of some of the language that you guys have been using. Roll the tape.
Right. Y'all are going into slavery for enslaving so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
You got it.
All right? That's what the Bible say, all right? So y'all can sit up here and listen. Y'all can take it as a joke. But guess what? All the atrocities that was done to our people, it's going to be done to you times two. All the cops.
Touch them.
Hey, don't touch me.
Hey!
Out
that
here,
is
man.
Uncalled
shit.
Get the out of here.
That's right.
All right, so that's pretty aggressive, rhetorically and physically. So the woman on the ground there. This is representative of that nationality. Anytime anybody hears about the Black Israelites, that's what they think of. Now, I know you're saying...
But that's not true.
They were taken to Cadre Memorial.
What's your point? Do you have any grievances coming up here?
Of course I have grievances.
So state your grievances, please.
That all men sexually harass women.
So you're saying, you're generalizing that all men sexually harass women. What do you define as harassment?
There's a kind of a broad spectrum between.
Kind of, right?
She never encountered.
Go ahead. There's, go ahead.
Shut the fuck up. You want to see the spectrum?
So do you want to have discourse or do you want to use profanity?
Well, first, there's interrupting me.
Okay, I'll let you speak. Go ahead, speak.
Yeah.
You got the floor.
Oh, really? Have I? Have you stopped interrupting me?
Go ahead.
No. It there's a spectrum, and it ranks from interrupting to demeaning to belittling to raping women.
So interrupting, right? So what I just did, that was a form of harassment.
He says,
"Yeah, get out of here, man. We ain't none of them guys, all right? You ain't about to come up here and call
I'm
no
sorry.
Spectacle. Call
I'm
the
sorry.
Cops.
Call the cops. Did any of you
call
see
cops.
Him just
yeah,
physically
yeah.
assault?
Call the cops.
Don't touch
me.
Hey,
fuck out
that
of here,
is
man.
Uncalled for.
Shut the fuck
scripts,
up.
Man.
Get the fuck out of here.
That's
all
right.
Scripts, all right?
Get the camera on. Get the
come
camera on.
Coming up here, cause admission. All right.
Death to America.
That's
death
right.
To America.
That's
death
right.
To America.
That's right.
Look at her trying to play the victim. The lady white. Go get the KKK, right?
Yes.
That's what the KKK is all
did
about, right?
Her?
Protecting white womanhood. She come up here trying to play the victim.
Yeah.
Come up here trying to play the victim.
Hey, get her.
Call
y'all better
the,
get
please.
Her.
Please call the cops. Call the police. All right. She came up here assaulting us. It's on camera.
That's right.
Look at her.
She came up assaulting us. She came up assaulting us. All
right. That's right.
Ain't nobody, I was being cordial with the lady, and look who you got to come to the rescue, right?
Nigga,
right?
Man.
Old Sambo, all right?
Nigga.
Get Proverbs 11 and 21, all right?
I'm on Mark.
Shut up, fall there, Rick. Is that not what she was trying to do?
But she resisted.
Oh, she fucking up. Get it, yeah.
Slam her head against the car.
Get her.
Taser.
Slam her on the ground.
Taser.
Come on, turn it off.
I remember a senator once asked me, when we talk about CIA, why we never use the word the in front of it? And I asked him, do you put the word the in front of God?
And this officially was released by the CIA, talking about how they have people embedded in all the major media to change, alter, and affect stories to their benefit.
You are fake news.
So every news agency, every television, radio station in the Albuquerque, Santa Fe area had our snitches in there. So we knew, and we paid them. We paid them good money. One of the reasons you get the people is you pay them. And that was controversial. That was somewhat controversial.
Do you know of national media that have had
some? Yes. Yeah, I'm not going to name them.
We now have relationship with reporters from every underlined major wire service, newspaper, Newsweekly, and television network in the nation. In many instances, we have persuaded reporters to postpone, change, hold, or even scrap stories that could have adversely affected national security interests or jeopardized our sources and methods. And it goes on to then say that they have the same within academic circles.
There's a finding that the Pike Committee made that they had verified 42 full-time Central Intelligence Agency paid employees that were inserted inside the major national news media centers. And most of them ended up being the so-called national security reporters.
The man turned to me, and this is a board member of Time Life, and said, Dr. Greer, we basically are scribes taking dictation from the right hand of the king. The fourth estate is dead.
I know reporters for Time Magazine who've told me specifically that they've provided the stories and their editors have spiked them.
Yeah, the high level producers and directors. Yeah.
And how were they paid? So that
cash. Yeah, you pay. What you do is you make them sign a form and you tell them, you got to report this to IRS. But whether they do it or not, you're not going to give your form to IRS. I better not say. Some of them are large.
If you, Ms. McClain, know of any proof about aliens, you can give it to me, and I guarantee you I will get it out. But I am skeptical.
Based upon my experience representing NBC and representing the New York Times, I know that they will refuse to publish information, which in my judgment is clearly important information for the public to know.
The corruption of the media means that you have then undermined democracy and our basic constitutional protections. Because if you control the information flow through the elite media, and the only place you can get this information is through the tabloids where they want it because it's discredited there, or on the internet where there's so much false information that's mixed in with the real information that you don't know what to make of it, there creates this complete confusion.
When you go to a supermarket checkout and you look at the tabloids, what you may be reading there are actual stories of actual events, but when it's portrayed through the tabloids, it gets discredited.
And they're ridiculed and their careers are destroyed, pursuant to a very specific self-conscious.
Let me check the hot sheets.
These are the hot sheets. Best investigator reporting on the planet. Go ahead, read the New York Times if you want to. They get lucky sometimes. Thanks, Manny.
Cannot believe you're looking for tips in the supermarket tabloids.
Not looking for. Found.
And they're ridiculed and their careers are destroyed, pursuant to a very specific self-conscious official program.
Now, this has worked for 50 years. Why would they change it now? This is the technique they've used.
So we're sort of living in a Truman Show here. Everyone thinks we have a free press. We don't. We have a democratic process where all these sort of sensitive issues would be handled legally. We do not. And that we have an uncorrupted scientific establishment, which we do not, and which we will prove.
The structure of secrecy extends to the scientific and academic arenas, where a deliberate effort to spread disinformation has been going on for decades. From professional debunkers to CIA-funded committees, our trusted academics and scientists have been complicit in the secrecy.